Hello friends, welcome back to my channel. Today I am going to share easy to make delicious haleem at home with simple ingredients yet very delicious. Like, share and subscribe to my channel. Live tasty, be happy. Let's get started. First, I am taking the dal varieties. What all I'll be adding? I am taking 2 tablespoons of urad dal and tur dal. Then moong dal is 1/4 cup and chana dal 1/4 cup, 1/4 cup of rice, and this is pearl barley, which is another 1/4 cup. I am just swapping it with the broken pearl barley which I have at home. If you don't have, no worries, you can take the whole pearly barley itself, or you can also replace it with broken wheat or even the whole wheat. Now first I am going to roast all the dal varieties in a pan with some 2 to 3 tablespoons of ghee. Nicely roast all the dal and rice so that it will give extra taste and nice aroma in the haleem. So do not skip this part. Roasting and soaking it will give nice extra flavor in the haleem. Now I'll be roasting it a little bit, not too much, just roast it. To that I will be adding dried rose petals. It is 1/2 to 1/4 cup of dried rose petals. This is also is going to give additional flavor to your haleem. If you get, surely use it, or at the end as the rose, add rose water to the haleem otherwise. Now I am just transferring all the roasted dal to a pressure cooker. In that I am adding 1 teaspoon of turmeric powder, 2 bay leaf, 1 stick of cinnamon, and add enough water. Do not be stingy in adding water. If you add enough water, the dal will not stick to the bottom while it is getting cooked. Now I will rest this dal 30 minutes so that it can soak nicely. After that, just open and give it a mix and on the pressure cooker. Pressure cooker, you should keep it for 5 minutes on high and 30 minutes on low. Next, we'll go to mutton. This is 1 kg of mutton with bones I have taken. Also, I have chopped 2 onions finely and kept aside. And I have taken some masala, that is turmeric, chili powder, dhania powder, garam masala, salt and green chilies. You can see on the screen what are the measurements I have taken. Now I am cooking it in another pot, that is Instapot. I have Instapot, I am going with it. If you don't have, no worry, you go for another cooker. In another large cooker, add enough oil. To that I am adding the onions. Nicely saute the onion until translucent, do not need to be brown. At this point I will be adding 1 tablespoon of ginger garlic paste. Nicely give it a good mix and fry until the raw smell is gone. Each and every step, fry them nicely so that any raw smell is taken off. The haleem is going to be very, very delicious. Now again, I'll saute the mutton with ginger garlic paste and onions. Just little bit. For 2 to 3 minutes, then I will be adding all the powdered masala and green chili and also the salt. Nicely give it a good mix and fry it again. If you have kebab chini, or what you can say it is dum kali mirchi they say otherwise, if you have that, do surely add it. That will also give nice extra taste, but I don't have it here. That will give a real haleem touch also. Now I have added little bit of water and I will cover it and cook. Generally I will cook in Instapot all mutton variety approximately 12 to 15 minutes, but now for haleem to cook nice, soft and tender, I am going to cook for 30 minutes in the Instapot. After 30 minutes, I gave a resting time of 35 minutes. Now I am just releasing the steam. Look, the tender mutton is ready. I will show you how tender it is. See, it is very, very tender. Just if you touch, it falls apart. Now I will be removing all the mutton pieces alone from the mix. Now I will be discarding all the bones out of the mutton. We will only keep the flesh in and discard all the bones. Now we don't need bones. Enough stock has come out of it. Again, you mix it inside the soup. If you don't have a hand blender, then before mixing it inside, run it in the mixer or grinder, whatever you have. I have hand blender. This makes my job very easy. I will just mash all the mutton and the liquid together with the help of this hand blender itself. This hand blender makes my job very, very easy. Nice, creamy, silky, smooth haleem will be ready if you mash this nicely at this point. See how nice, we don't have any small pieces in it. Now let's check on the dal. This dal also you run the hand blender if you have. Otherwise, before adding it to the mutton, you just discard these bay leaves and run it in the mixer. But I didn't do that. I will just use the hand blender everywhere. Now after blending, I am going to mix the mutton mix and the dal mix together in one single pot. Either of the pot you can mix. I am mixing it into the Insta pot. To that I have added little bit of fried onions. I have saved little bit of the fried onions for garnishing also. Again I added salt, little bit of ghee and also the rose petals. If you don't have rose petals, don't worry. I have also added the garam masala. If you don't have rose petals, you go with rose water or rose essence, little bit. Rose essence means you have to just add it in drops. Rose water means you can add little more. That rose flavor will give extra taste to the haleem. Give it a good mix and again I am running the hand blender so that nothing is left over without giving a good mix. It will not come to this consistency. See how nice silky smooth haleem is ready. Now I have prepared all these garnishing, that is fried onions, cashews fried in ghee, ginger julienne and coriander. Also I will be squeezing some lemon and ghee on top. This all toppings is going to give extra taste to the haleem. Just you need is all the right ingredients and two pressure cooker. Your work will be done in no time. Patiently you follow these steps, you will have a very delicious homemade mazedar haleem in just no time. Hope you all like it. Thanks for watching. Like, share and subscribe to my channel. Live tasty, be happy. Bye bye.